Yes, students, welcome all of you. Myself, C.A. Sanjay Mutreja. I'll be taking chapter Reconstitution of Partnership Firm, that is admission, in detail today. Let us begin with the chapter. First of all, we will start with the meaning of partnership. Partnership means an agreement between two or more persons who are sharing the profits or losses in an agreed ratio. And the most important thing, in a mutual agency way. Now, what do you mean by mutual agency? Both are agent and principal for each other. Suppose there are two partners, A and B. When A is working on behalf of B, he is an agent of B. And when B is working on behalf of A, he is the agent of A. So, both are mutually principal and agent for each other. This is the meaning of mutual agency. In partnership, we are working together and we can work for the other party also. Now, in this chapter of Reconstitution, we will be dealing with five things. First, admission, which will be in very detail. Change in profit sharing ratio. Next, retirement. Then, death of a partner, and in the last we'll be dealing with insolvency of a partner. Let us start with admission in detail now. Yes, in admission of a partner, first thing to note down is why will we admit another partner. There are two reasons for that. First, for expansion purpose, and second, for supplementing the resources in case of expansion. If you need some person for help or you need some money for expansion purpose, you must have another person in your board, and this is called admission of a partner. But please remember, we need consent of all the partners for doing this. Next point, what the new partner brings in the business. Naturally, he will bring money, that is capital, and he will also bring premium. Premium means goodwill. Why will he bring goodwill? Because the old partners who were doing the business for such a long time have earned some kind of reputation for their business. So, he will be compensating them for that part. This is called premium. The following point should be considered in case of admission of a partner. The first important point is, what will be the new ratio in case of new admission of a partner? Second point, we have to think about what the old partners are sacrificing, that is sacrificing ratio. We'll be coming to the questions. Third point to be discussed is goodwill. Goodwill means premium. What are the methods of valuation? What is the accounting treatment of goodwill? That we'll be also studying in detail. And next, the most important practical part is revaluation of assets and liabilities. Next, what will we do with the accumulated profits and reserve as on the date of admission of a partner? And the last point is, how will be capital adjusted on the admission of a new partner? Let us understand this with the help of few examples. A and B are old partners sharing the profits in the ratio of 3:2. When we admit a new partner C for 1/4 share, now how will we calculate the new ratio and sacrificing ratio? Let us start with calculating the new ratio. Let total ratio is equal to 1. Because when we start with 1. After C, the balance will be 1 minus 1 by 4, that is 3/4. Now, nothing is mentioned for A and B. So, what will we do is, whatever balance is there, we will divide it between A and B in the same ratio. that is 3:2. In this way, a new ratio is equal to 3/4, the balance, into his original share, that is 3/5. It makes it 9/20. So, this is the new ratio of A, 9/20. Similarly, B new ratio is equal to the remaining 3/4 into his original share, that is 2/5, 6/20. So, now we have arrived at A new ratio and B new ratio, and C ratio, you know, that is 1/4. But in order to make it 20, what we will do is multiply by 5/5, so as to arrive in a common denominator, right? So, it makes it 5/20. Now, if we want to check that we have calculated it correct or not, let us do it like this. The new ratio is 9/6/5. Total this ratio, it is coming to 20. That means we have calculated it correctly, 9/20, 6/20 and 5/20. So, this is our correct answer. So, this is the way to check also, right? Now, what is the sacrificing ratio in this? Now, sacrificing ratio means, sacrificing ratio is equal to old minus new. Let us calculate it. A sacrifice, what was the old ratio of A? 3/5. What is the new ratio of A? 9/20. Let us take the LCM now. This will be 12 minus 9, that is 3/20. Similarly, we can calculate the sacrificing ratio for B in this way. B sacrifice is equal to old ratio minus, what was the new ratio? Yes, 6/20. Take the LCM again, 20. 8 minus 6, this is 2/20. So, the sacrifice ratio of A and B again comes to 3:2, which was the old ratio. So, we can derive one point from this. If nothing is mentioned about the new ratio of the old partners, then it will be the same ratio as the old ratio. And this is true for all. We can check this in some questions also. So, please remember, when nothing is mentioned about the new ratio of the old partners and only new partner ratio is given, the old ratio is always equal to sacrificing ratio. Now, let us come to another question and check this again. A and B, old partners, ratio 3:1. C is admitted for 1/5 share, which he gets equally from A and B. Now, see, C is getting equal share from A and B. Now, how to do this question? Balance share is equal to 1 minus 1/5, 4/5. Now, if you will divide this 4/5 in 3:1, it will not give you correct answer, because what C is getting is equally from A and B. Let us see what C is getting from A and what C is getting from B. A sacrifice for C is 1/5 × 1/2, that is 1/10. 1/10 from A and similarly 1/10 from B. How? Let us see. B sacrifice is also 1/5 × 1/2. Now both A and B are sacrificing 1/10 in favor of C. Whatever they are sacrificing is the gain of C. We can check also gain of C, 1/10 + 1/10 = 2/10. 2/10 means 1/5. Hence proved, whatever A and B are sacrificing will be the new share or gain of C, right? Now let us understand sacrificing ratio and new ratio in this. A new ratio, 3/4 - 1/10, and B new ratio is 1/4 - 1/10. Because previously we were having 3:1, and now they have sacrificed 1/10, 1/10 each. Now A new ratio will be, and B new ratio will be, and C new ratio was 1/10 + 1/10, that is 2/10. And if you want to make it 40, what will you do? Yes, multiply numerator and denominator by 4 each to get 40. Now the new ratio becomes 26, 6, and 8. Let us check again. 26 and 6 is 32, and 32 and 8 is 40. Yes, we are right. So in this case we have first calculated what was the sacrifice of the old partner, and then we have calculated the new ratio. Now you know the sacrifice. If you want to recheck, apply the formula again, old minus new ratio, and if you get the same answer, that means we are correct. Let us check it again. Sacrifice of A is old minus new ratio. Old ratio 3/4 minus new ratio 26/40. Let us check. It is 4/40. I know this will also come as 4/40 again. And 4/40 means 1/10 each, which was our answer. So that means we are correct. So you can cross check your things also. So by cross checking you can always understand the basics, as well as you can also understand that we are doing it right or not. To conclude, what we have done today is, first of all we understood the meaning of partnership, and then we have taken two topics, new ratio and sacrificing ratio, along with understanding what the new partner is going to bring in, that is his capital and goodwill. So in our next topic, what we will be doing is goodwill, revaluation and the remaining things in this chapter. Till then, goodbye. Thank you very much.